grab your friendly plastic and your clear nail varnish because I'm going to show you a great technique to create faux dichroic beads in friendly plastic. We're going to take the technique of creating your friendly plastic beads with the cloud clay cores a step further. So you're still going to need your cloud clay. You're still going to make your cloud clay cores, but you're also going to need some nail varnish. I'm using a frosted. It's a clear frosted or clear glitter, works very well too. Make sure it's clear or it has a little bit of glitter. You don't want anything that has an opaque color for this technique. So the first thing you're going to do is you can choose any color of friendly plastic that you want. I'm working with the avocado green here. It's kind of a lime green and it's really, really pretty. And you're going to either put on little dots of the nail polish, the nail varnish, or you can add stripes. Now you can play around with different patterns, but keep it fairly simple because in my experiments the more complex patterns just don't show up as well. So keep it fairly simple, add dots all the way across your friendly plastic, or cover at least the entire piece of your friendly plastic with either dots or stripes and let that dry. Next, turn it upside down onto your non-stick work surface and apply your heat. I'm going to roll my core into a log that is about the length or the width of the plastic here, and it's about a quarter of an inch in diameter. It doesn't have to be perfect, but it needs to be fairly even. I'm going to set that on the edge, and then I'm going to lift the friendly plastic off of my non-stick sheet here, and I'm going to roll it until the edges meet. Roll it back and forth and make sure that your seam is closed. Pinch your edges. Now, to shape your bead, what you're going to do is you're going to hold this into your hand. Remember that the friendly plastic is still hot and warm, so it's still malleable, and your cloud clay core there gives it enough stability to hold the shape. So I am going to just press flat and use my hands to shape this into a focal bead. And the more that you stretch out the clay, the more that your pattern is going to become visible, just like that. You'll want to let your bead cool and rest a little bit before you come back in and insert your needle tool to poke the hole through your bead. I generally will put a piece of wire and loop both ends. I like to wire wrap mine, so let's take a look at my finished sample. For more friendly plastic ideas, tips, and inspiration, visit us on our blog at friendlyplastic.blogspot.com. And be sure to check out all of our YouTube videos on our channel at Friendly Plastic TV.